My name is Jenna Beaver. I am a graduate student and a research assistant in the Memory and Aging Lab at Washington State University. So my primary job in the lab is to assess older adults for their cognitive abilities. Basically, that involves putting them through different tasks to see how their thought processes are working and what kinds of things they might be having difficulty with. And then we can use that to then see also how they're doing in their real life, so how they're performing regular activities that they have to do every day, and we want to investigate the relationships between those two things. So I grew up in Pennsylvania on the East Coast, and I got an undergraduate degree in psychology at George Mason University in Virginia. And then I knew I wanted to do more research, so I came out here to Washington State University to work with Dr. Schmitter-Edgecombe in her Memory and Aging Lab. My mom is a preschool teacher, and my dad is an engineer, so no one else in my family is in research. Math is not my favorite subject, but I've learned to sort of do the things that I need to do in my job and in my research, and it hasn't been a very difficult hurdle to get over, but numbers still scare me a little bit. When I was in college, I completed an undergraduate thesis, and there was a mentor that I had there, and she is a professor at George Mason University, and she really showed me that research can be a lot of fun, and it's really fun to wonder about things and then ask those questions, and that while it can be a lot of hard work, sometimes it's also really rewarding, and so she was kind of one of the main forces that led me to go to graduate school. So for this next task, I want you to just do what I do. So I want you to touch the box that I touch in the same order, okay?
Okay.
So my main job in the lab is to assess older adults and their cognitive abilities, so things like problem solving and memory. And so I sit down with them, we do 3-hour batteries. So I sit down with them and we have a bunch of different tasks that they do. And then we look at how they're performing. And so the short-term goals are to see the relationships between how they're performing on these tasks and how they are actually functioning in their everyday lives. So how difficulties in things like memory might be affecting their ability to do things like cook or clean or maintain their finances. And the long-term goals and implications of that research is hopefully to help people remain independent longer. So to develop technologies or coping strategies for them that will help them get through those cognitive difficulties and still maintain their ability to function every day. Our lab is really collaborative, both within our lab and then with other departments in the university as well. So it's a lot of fun to bounce ideas off of people and to get help from other people who might have strengths that are different than your own. I think my ideal goal is just to help individuals stay independent. A lot of these older adults that I work with, when I sit down and I do testing with them, they'll tell me about difficulties that they're having in their lives, and it can be really, really stressful to experience those changes, especially when people are used to being independent, being able to do everything on their own for their whole life. Going into research science is both rewarding, but it's also really fun. And so being able to work with the older adults that we work with, you really get to see the individuals that you're aiming to help, and that's really rewarding to be able to talk with them and then go home and do this data analysis that's actually gonna help them in the long run. It's a pretty fun process that allows you to be pretty creative.